We have a 6-week long program that takes you both from 0 to 1, and you can become a team member.
It was perfect opportunity for me. As I said, they were very supportive. They give me every single moment they have free. They help me to get my feet wet. And now, officially, I'm part of the team.
Hi, my name is Eddie, and I'm here at HackConf 2019 in Sofia, Bulgaria. And it's been an amazing day. It's still early on, but wonderful day. People have been so welcoming, all keen to talk and share their what they've learned, what they want to learn this weekend. The venue is massive. It's really spacious. It's really clean. So it's been a really good event. Everyone's been really friendly. They've really enjoyed the event. They've made a real big effort to have gluten-free snacks, to cater for everyone's needs. I highly recommend coming to this conference. We've still got another day and a half to go. We're the Dashboard Hub team. We're really excited to talk to more people, see how it's gone, and hear how everyone's enjoyed the event.
Hi, my name's Eddie. We're at HackConf 2019 in Sofia in Bulgaria. And it's an amazing event. And we're talking about open source, and Kiwi TCMS team are here with me. And we're here to talk about open source, mentoring, how to get you contributing to open source, to a mature, awesome project. Let's hear from the team members, enough from me. So tell us, give us a brief overview. What is Kiwi TCMS? Really quick overview of what it is so people can understand, and we'll dive straight into your mentorship program, your commit, your pull request you did yesterday. I can't wait to hear more about it.
I'm a recently core team member, and I'm in charge of the mentorship program. I'm onboarding people that are interested in open source and want to get their feet wet with Python, both on the backend and through Django on the MVC site. And we have a 6-week long program that take you both from 0 to 1, and you can become a team member. Esther Duslav.
Yeah, hi from me. I am one of the fresh team members in the team. I have interest in Python and Django, and get in touch with the guys from the team, and I can say they were very supportive. They helped me get my first steps in Python, and from tomorrow I have more than 20 commits in the main repository, and I get shirt from them. And officially I am core team member now, and I'm very proud of it.
That's awesome. So that's great work and you were saying last night. So we had HackConf yesterday, and in the evening you did your pull request for at the end of HackConf for Kiwi TCMS, which you can see on GitHub. I'll put a screenshot in of your pull request now. Let's wind back. So the onboarding sounds amazing, and I can't wait to drill into what's involved in that 6 weeks. But for yourself, let's hear more about what did you do, say, when did you start getting involved, and what did you do before that? So I want to know more about that transition. So when did you start contributing or speaking to the Kiwi TMS team?
I think I know the guys a few years back, but I started contributing in the, I think it was middle of May.
Okay.
And I passed the training this few
and
weeks. Yeah. And in the beginning of August, I started committing to the main repository.
Okay.
Before that, and in my day-to-day job, I am backend engineer, mainly with web development. And I started interesting about Python and Django. What are the best practices? What are the other versioning control system that can be used? As I know the guys, it was perfect opportunity for me. And as I said, they were very supportive. They give me every single moment they have free. They help me to get my feet wet. And now, officially, I'm part of the team.
That's great. So the 6 weeks mentoring program, you said.
Yeah.
And what does that sort of entail? Like, what's week one like? What's week two like? Does it get more difficult as you go
along? Yeah, we start you off. You suppose you don't have much experience.
Okay.
You may be not exactly Python developer. You may be really early, like just finishing high school or something, student. We start you off with Git, because in order to get any code in, you need to know Git. And that's the primary step. Then we start you off with Python code, like simple functions. We build you off through classes. And then these are basically five modules that take you through Python. And then you start building a web application with Django, which is another few modules. And then by the week six, you should be well off and then ready to get into the real project.
I mean, that sounds great. So is your mentoring program actually open source on GitHub? Can people see what
of
it looks
course.
Like?
Of course, you need to have a public repo, okay. And then you need to fork the projects with the tutorials, and then everybody can see that you did this repo, and then you can use that for your own benefit as well, building your portfolio for future interviews, and if you want to improve your technology background and stuff.
It's so true. I mean, open source and building a portfolio is so important.
Yeah.
And people have a polished, oh, this is what it looks like, is a screenshot of a website build. That doesn't mean anything because, you know, you could have been involved in it, but you might not have done it. But when you've got it, like you said, forked on your own GitHub account, I can see what contributions you made, what contributions the other person made, rather than something, oh, I was part of this massive, amazing project. And it's great.
Yeah, in many cases, me as an interviewee, I've been asked, like, are you part of any open source project? Have you been part of any open source project? And it's really something that comes up really often.
Yeah, and in our day-to-day job as a developer, I use many thousands of libraries. And I know someone stay late at night and...
hammering out.
Yeah, and do some code. And now as I return small part to the community, I'm happy with it. Yeah.
And it's just such a great way to learn, such a great way to network and build your portfolio. So many big benefits. It is Hacktoberfest this month. Are you both aware of Hacktoberfest?
Yeah.
How many?
We're getting the t-shirt.
Nice. That's what I like to hear. Definitely do Hacktoberfest. I think it's great. So everyone watching, do Hacktoberfest. If you need help, you know who to ask. They've got a mentoring program getting you contributing to open source. And I think it's brilliant. And Python is so popular. The web world is also popular in data science.
It's really popular with lots of things that are really hot at the moment. Like you said, big data,
machine learning,
analysis of any sort and kind. Because many companies say we're data first. Yeah. Well, data processing takes like Python and helps you really understand what your client or what your client base is doing with your product.
Yeah, I completely agree. What's next for you? Do you plan to obviously contribute more? Do you plan to maybe get more people into the mentoring program as well and saying that, you know?
Yeah. As we are currently at the HackConf,
which 2019.
Is great. Yeah, it's a great event. We here communicate with many people and we offer them that we are open source project. They can become contributors, and there are many young people which don't know where to start. And I think this one is one great opportunity.
I think you're right. The hardest part of most things, especially open source, is where to start, how to start, because there's just so much
going on. Find the community. Find people that likes you and want to help you succeed.
Yeah, there are team members like Alex, which has, I don't know, more than 10 years of experience. And these people are ready to give their free time for you to learn and to give you some push to start and to get involved.
And I highly recommend joining them. And also Alex is also, I met him in Fosdem earlier this year.
We did a video together. We're all going to be at Fosdem.
And we're going to see you next year at Fosdem. So it was great. My Dashboard Hub stand was next to Alex and we had many great conversations. And he's the one that told me about HackConf and organized this for us to come. And we were so happy we came, having an amazing time. So yes. So anything else you want to add or me to ask or?
Yeah, on the last topic, I want to add that we are talking about freshening up and getting more spice into the process of people getting around the stand and doing something more engaging. And then really understanding what is the test management system about. Because now they see some written posters, they see the logo, they see the GitHub, but then if we can engage them for a few minutes with some some nice things, the sorts of the little onboard computers and something to really a few lines of code that something will happen and then it's easy to complete. We have this kind of ideas with Alex and we'll probably launch them for the first them next year.
Oh, awesome. I can't wait. Have you applied for a stand and all is good?
Yeah, we have a dev room. We've applied to a stand.
We're going to apply to your dev room as well.
Yeah, and I want to finish with a quote. There is no reasonable excuse to do less than your best.
Exactly. Awesome. Let's do it. Let's see what happens.